Hey, I'm Nader from NVIDIA.
I'm Matt from NVIDIA.
Hey, this is Ozzy.
We just finished GTC. What an incredible week. You know, my first time on the inside, so.
Yeah, man, it's been really awesome. It's been like a lot, but a lot of amazing stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's great to see the way things are growing. It's awesome.
Yeah, I think from last year, GTC, till this year, the biggest difference I saw was like the theme of companies. Last year, I think a big focus was making sure that there was access to GPUs. How are we using them? What do our developer workflows look like? But I feel like the big sentiment that I heard this year was almost like it split. It was something way deeper down to the data center. And I heard the word data center so much this year. And I saw a lot of surface level applications where, you know, seeing people actually use all the infrastructure that was talked about last year, or all the platforms rather. And it feels like as GPUs are now getting utilized, where the issue becomes, how do we get more power to the land?
So perfect example of this is sort of the journey we've been able to watch folks go through with Inception. You know, there are companies that came in as community members to us. Now they're sponsors. Now they're offering benefits to each other. It's great. We have folks that can take advantage of our 100K of credits, do some great work on a DGX, or reach out to some of our partners. We've got services for folks who are doing LLMs, robotics, guardrails, everything.
Yeah, the amount of value that startups can get from Inception right now is insane. I think, you know, even for us, we joined Inception, and it's a great way for NVIDIA to get to know what your startup's doing. It's a great way for you to kind of like meet folks where you can see what a partnership could look like. But even to see this 100K credit program, you know, if you're able to offer 100K of GPU credits to a startup, that could just really unlock something that they otherwise wouldn't have been able to do. You know, there's a couple of great success cases that I think are outlined in the blog. What are the companies? Roboflow, Dicta.
We had BioTurn as well.
Yeah.
So folks are doing model training, new development, wildly accelerating. It's wonderful.
Speaking of Inception, one thing I love about the program is that as much as a startup is able to lean in, NVIDIA leans in as well. At different stages or maturities of the company. Are there any kind of like breakouts that come to mind?
Yeah. One that's great is Bria. They do image generation. They probably worked with us the first time, 2 years ago. We were helping them with TRT optimization for their models. And now they're offering actually benefits to other Inception members through some of the things we launched just on Tuesday. So just kind of the whole journey.
It's great to see the new Inception benefits for startups, but not just startups. NVIDIA is doing some really cool work with VCs.
Yeah, we've got a whole VC alliance. Basically, every VC I talked to at GTC just loved it, right? It's sort of a mutual connection between members and VCs who are looking for new folks for their portfolio. It's been so successful, we actually are seeing sort of an evolution of that, where folks who are part of A16Z now are getting exclusive benefits with early access to GB200. So it's really, again, that whole journey through Inception, all coming to fruition. It's just awesome to see.
Yeah, early access to the latest from NVIDIA definitely seems like for an investor to be value add.
Yeah, another thing that was just getting mobbed about, everybody seems to be super excited, is Spark. So
yeah,
what'd you think of that?
As a developer, it's really nice to be able to have local hardware that 100%. I'm just in my own environment. I have Bash set up the way that I like my shell, just everything the way I like it for my development workloads. But now being able to do that with access to, what is it, 128 gigs of unified memory. And I saw that announcement, and I also saw like the Llama Nematron announcement, the 49B supermodel. Yeah. And was like instantly like, oh my gosh, that's a multi-agent setup on my local with the supermodel as kind of the main agent, but all these 8B, 3B SLM models, and I'm running it all locally before I wrap it up and deploy it to serverless. Like, sounds amazing.
Yeah, I've been super excited about DGX Spark, and It's been really fun to kind of see how far along the progression has been happening internally of the developer experience. So, you know, it's a Grace Blackwell device. Grace Blackwell is something that you typically need from a workstation or from the cloud. And, you know, these are really powerful systems, which means that they're also, they cost a bit.
Yeah.
And so being able to have a Grace Blackwell that's local where you're not paying for you to be able to kick the tires or fine tune or train and you get 128 gigs of memory. It's huge. Just being the personal cloud, the local device, the security that you get from that. And also having that much power at the edge, I think is going to unlock a whole bunch of use cases.
Yeah, I see we're also doing stuff at kind of both ends of the stack or of scale. So we've got serverless, which sort of runs the gamut, but is wonderful for folks who are starting out. But then we had announcements of Dynamo, which seems to serve the really, really high-end optimized cases. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. Like honestly, I want to know more. I know that you guys did a podcast
about it recently. Yeah, we were very lucky to sit down with Kyle Cannon, who's one of the Dynamo architects. Dynamo brings, it's like up to 30x throughput on models like DeepSeek R1. That's a crazy improvement. But I think some of the optimizations come down to disaggregating the inference on the GPU.
Right.
So where you're doing anything with KV cache versus actually spitting tokens out, those can happen on different GPUs. And then there's intelligent KV routing. So you can essentially like route you to the GPU with the KV cache that you need. I think the other optimization was moving KV cache off the GPU memory right into cold storage.
Yeah, yeah.
So that becomes really useful for use cases like if you have, if you're going to reference a code repo, instead of having to recalculate the KV cache for that repo every time it's used, you can just have that somewhere in cold storage. But it was on the front page of Hacker News when it was launched. I think it's the community's already excited about it. So, Dynamo and the speeds that you can now get for inference definitely feel like a game changer. It was an amazing GTC. I think definitely the most jam-packed one that I've seen. I loved seeing how much this one was able to build on top of everything that was announced from last year. How much more we're getting out of the data centers, how much more compute can be built online. I think seeing the graphs from Jensen's keynote about everything that's coming, we're definitely in the age of agentic AI, and this is going to be a really exciting year.
Yeah, no, it's a great time to be building, right? There's benefits everywhere, regardless of what you're doing, who you are. It's an exciting time.
Yeah, it definitely feels like we're in one of the most like pivotal moments of humanity. So excited to see everything that comes from the rest of this year, and can only imagine what could get announced at GTC next year.